Hello students, this is the second part of prelims 1 paper for geography subject. So we were already discussing about the difference between. So this is the last difference between, that is possibilism and determinism. So what is possibilism? When a man dominates the nature, then it is called as possibilism. And opposite to it is when a nature dominates a man, then it is called as determinism. So in the case of possibilism, due to the intelligence, man makes changes in the natural environment. And in the case of determinism, assets that development of human history, culture, society and lifestyle are shaped under the physical environment. So in the case of possibilism, there is a limitation to change what is made by man in nature. But in the case of determinism, there is no limitation of physical environment on human activities. Okay. Now we'll see about the map. As it's already told that there are some points which you have to allocate on the map. Okay, so that points we'll discuss. So here is some continental that supports continent that supports 1% of the population. Okay, so I'll just take the map here, or I'll just take this down so it will be easy for us to see it. Okay, along with the map. Okay, so a continent that supports less than one person population is the Antarctica continent, and that is being highlighted here. Okay, next we have a country in stage 2, early expanding in demographic transition. So there are countries like Nigeria, then Congo, Bangladesh. So these are some of the countries which comes under stage 2, that is also highlighted here. Then a class 1 city in India. So Mumbai is one of the class 1 city in India. So that is highlighted. Then a country that has developed plantation agriculture. So you can see a country which has developed plantation agriculture is nothing but it is Malaysia, Singapore. So the fourth point is highlighted on the map, as you can see here. Then we have an industrial region in USA. So in USA, New England is an industrial region, 5 number, which is highlighted here. Then we have Canada Pacific Railway Line, 6 number, which is plotted with black color line with dash. A dense populated river basin in North Africa. So it is nothing but, just a minute, it is nothing but Nile River, so which is plotted by 7 number in between. And a region having tropical rainforest in South America is Amazon forest, which is plotted as follows in the 8th section. Okay, here. Okay, now we'll move towards the next question. So this is how you have to make a use of color pencil and highlight the maps. Now here we have read the following map and graphs. Okay, and then you have to answer the following question. So looking at this graph, this is a bar graph. Okay, so what is shown in the diagram? So what is shown, this is shown. That is the death rate of children under 5 years per 1,000 live births. Okay, of different countries like Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. So these are the things which is shown here. Then we have named the cartographic technique. So the technique which is used to show these details is the bar graph. Next, name the country having highest death rate of children under 5 years of age. So large amount of death rate is seen in India. So the answer is India. What is the death rate of children under 5 years in China? So here is China. So you can see it's 20. So it's 20 per life birth rate. And name the country having the lowest death rate under 5 years of age. So lowest is Russia, as you can see by looking at the graph. So these were the answers for it. Now next is short notes. In the case of short notes, the first short note is related to branches of geography. So there are major branches of geography like physical geography, human geography, as well as geography techniques. Okay, so these are the sub branches which we can see. And again, there are four branches like geomorphology, climatology, biogeography, oceanography. So how they are connected and what are the things which are newly launched, like remote sensing, qualification methods, cartography, geographic information system, that is GPS, GIS, okay, all these things you can mention here. Next is factor affecting regional development. So there are some factors which are affecting the regional development. So these are the factors like physical factors, climate, location, Okay, what is the climate, whether it is favorable, unfavorable? Okay, how is the location, whether it is plain or it is hilly surface? Then, whether it is near to the water body, coastal area. So such type of things you need to require in this answer. Next is tourism and GDP. Now, how it is connected with each other. Now, tourism is very important. It plays an important role in the economic condition of any of the country. Okay, it boosts the job of the people. Okay, it also creates job in agricultural, communication, health, as well as educational sector. The government that depends on tourism in waste of lot of infrastructure of the country. Okay, so basically you need to make something attractive so that the tourism may increase. So basically their focus is on infrastructure. Then the construction of highways, airports are done on a large amount of quantity so as the people should easily come to those places and they must get attracted towards those places. Next is footloose industries. Now we all know what is a footloose industry. So it is a type of industry where the raw material is used as well as finished products are used, but they are lightweight. Anywhere you can relocate these types of industries. The examples of these industries are diamond cutting, computer chips, mobile manufacturing. Okay, you don't require a specific location. For this, you get the raw material everywhere, wherever it is available. And the people required for such type of work is also available on many places. So because of that, these industries are called as footloose industries. Next, we have stage 5 of demographic transition theory. So in this transition theory, this is the last stage. So in this stage, the birth rate is also low and the death rate is high. Okay, so you can see that. The large number of old people, the death rate is high, and due to smaller number of young people, the birth rate is low. So here basically the tertiary and quaternary activity is more, the standard of living is very much high, there is lot of burden on healthy environment as well as comfortable life is seen. So the countries which are going under this stage is Sweden, Norway, Finland. Okay, these are the countries. Next is classification of industry based on the raw materials. Now we all know that based on raw materials, the industries are classified as agro-based industries, mineral-based, forest-based, marine-based and pastoral-based. So agricultural dependency is totally agro-based, like jam, jelly, sherbet, fruits. Okay. Then mineral-based industries are petrol industry, kerosene. Okay. Then we have forest industries, like we get the products like rubber, scented oil, sandalwood. These are the forest-based industries. We have marine-based industries where we get the products like fish oil, fish is used for medicinal purposes, ointments. Then we need a pastoral-based, which is totally dependent on animal husbandry. Next is the question dependent on paragraph writing. So this is a paragraph and you need to answer the questionnaires. So what is the important characteristic of El Nino? So El Nino is one of the most predictable climate event on the planet. So this is the answer for it. What is the effect of El Nino on the continent Africa? It is linked to drought and harvest failures on African continent. Next, name the countries affected by El Nino in South America. So Paraguay, Uruguay, Brazil and Argentina is the answer. What is the meaning of term El Nino? So El Nino is a blister of sea surface heat that every few years floats eastwards across the tropical Pacific Ocean. So it is also called as child because they became aware of it around the Christmas season as the fish catches failed. So when does El Nino appear on the tropical Pacific Ocean? It appears on the Christmas season. What was the last warmest year? So it is 1998. What could make El Nino more frequent and more devastating? So the warmest record, as the global warming is increasing, such type of warmest record, a delay in the monsoon region, seasons, rains. So this can make El Nino more frequent. Give a suitable title for the paragraph. So a title is a nature event, El Nino. Okay. Next, we have a diagram section where we have to draw a diagram based on the relationships of geography with other subjects. Again, we have the diagram which is the map by the Strabo. Then we have the patterns like radial pattern, angular pattern. And the last diagram question is regarding demographic transition theory. Now we have a question answering detail. So the first question is related to explain the relationship between geography and other subjects. So we all know that geography is related to several subjects like natural as well as social science, physical as well as human geography, cartography. So here we have to mention about the landforms, gradient, rock structures. Along with that, we can mention about temperature, winds, rainfall in the case of climatology. In the case of oceanography, you can tell about ocean currents, ocean routes, coastal features. In the case of geography of soil, you can tell about the texture, the layer, or the fertility of the soil. In the case of pedology, so these are some of the different geography sectors which we can talk. Okay, there is also political geography, economic geography, behavioral geography, and you can just describe the answers related to it. Next is development of transportation is dependent on geographical factors. So we all know that yes, if the geographical factors are convenient, then only you can develop a transportation. It is very difficult to develop a transportation in a forest area, dense forest area, hilly mountains. Okay, it is very difficult to construct a railway line on such places. So a broken coastal line is very much favorable for ports, as we all know. A plain surface is very much good for airports. Okay, so wherever there is continuous snowfalls, fog, smog, so such places the airports cannot be created because it works as an obstacle for aeroplanes. Next question is, explain the impact of migration on population structure of the country. So we all know that migration is a very important factor. Because of migration, there is always a change in the composition of population. People always move from one place to another place. So a place from where a person starts moving, that place is called as donor region. And a place where a person moves and settles, so that place is called as recipient region. So due to migration of people, there are the changes in the age structure. Okay, so the donor region, you can see there is less amount of young population because they move to the recipient region. Okay, and in the case of donor region, the dependency ratio is more, the female ratio is more. Okay, so there is always a change in the age structure. The sex ratio in this recipient region goes down in many big cities of India. Sex ratio is less than 85% to 90%. In recipient region, the percentage of working population is increasing rapidly, as well as there is a lot of burden on the facilities, public welfare facilities in the recipient region. The resources are not adequate to fulfill the consumption of such type of population. There is more working population than non-working population, which helps in the economic development of the region. So you can say that the recipient region starts developing more as the younger population is attracted towards it, and the donor region is developing less because they have large number of dependencies, and because of that the development is less. So this is all about the paper discussion of prelims 1. So both the parts I've already uploaded. You can go through it. If any query, if any confusion in any answer, you can comment in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to the channel.